We all have at least one dream that is not necessarily wise. After all, dreams are dreams for a reason, so they not careful considerations that come from our heads, they more a heartfelt desire to defy any logic. Such a dream for me has always been living in a beautiful house. I spend a lot of time inside my house. I'm a total homebody, and I happen to like uncluttered, minimalist, modern spaces. Something a more traditional British person would call empty boxes. So anything like Victorian houses with all the intricate bits and period features completely don't appeal to me. I love clean, empty rooms. They help me relax, and relaxation is the main thing I expect from my home. At some point, the plan was for me to redo this house. Together with my ex-partner, we decided that this would be our base and we would make it great. We took some equity out of the house, we hired an architect, and we started working on our idea of a dream place in London. We were not millionaires, we didn't do anything that would have made us ones. So our house project was pretty modest, all within our means. The architect, one of the few interested in a project this size, used to be a local but moved further out. We liked it here, but we were priced out, he said. It's a common London housing story. We chatted a few times, we told him we wanted a bigger kitchen, a better home studio, and more space in general. He listened, took notes, and finally appeared with the plans of his vision. This here, this is what the house looks like now. So you have the first floor, which is the ground floor, and the second and the outside. He made something simple, he said, but then talked to his wife and decided to change things around. And who knows, maybe you would like that. We all leaned over the plants. There's the extension right here in the back garden. It's not a typical full width of the room add-on. He turned it 90 degrees anti-clockwise. He also leaned it on the boundary wall, and that way gave us more privacy and almost double the size of the ground floor. He announced that it turns out that our garden was quite large. So we were not keen gardeners, so we were quite pleased to see it transformed and utilized as an outside dining space, not as a pastime. So the extension would become the living room. Then the kitchen would be moved to the center of the house, the heart of the house, current living room. And the current kitchen would become a studio or a home office, depending on how you choose to call it. That was downstairs. Upstairs, he'd get rid of the water tank, making the second bedroom bigger, and then reduce its size by slightly enlarging the bathroom. Windows were to be replaced in the whole house, walls to be replastered, underfloor heating to be installed on the ground floor and in the bathroom upstairs. We really liked the project. The architect really nailed our needs and gave us more than we expected. We also liked that he kept in mind what the house looks like. So it wasn't just an extension that we see so many built in the area. It was in the same style, if you may say so, about this very modest house. It would be just using brickwork, similar color, and soldier brick layering, which is quite nice. I really like architecture, and I really think that if you building a house or an extension or doing something, do it well instead of just adding something that is complying with the building regulations, looks ugly but is practical. I mean, function is important, but so is form. So together with my ex-partner, we really loved the project and we decided to go for it. And then we changed our mind. It did not happen immediately. We got the planning permission, which is still valid as the work has been started. But we stopped working with the original architect because things started dragging And we were constantly switching between, yes, let's do it, and no, let's not do it. Later on, we hired a new, more organized architect, and we got the evaluation of the building work. Our original budget was £100,000, and that's when we started questioning this whole dream, because the amount in the estimation was £140,000 plus VAT. So that was far more than what we were hoping to spend and prepared to spend. Sure, we'd be adding another bedroom to the house and increasing its value. At the same time, we would need to seriously stretch our budget. And we both knew that evaluation didn't include everything. It was for the building work, it was for the windows, but not for the finishing touches. And if you've ever watched property renovation shows like this one, or this one, or this one, you know that everybody goes over their budget, contingency plan, and wishful thinking pot. So we gave up. Our relationship dissolved not long after. So in hindsight, we saved ourselves a lot of stress. But what's more important, we stayed free. Had we gone on with that house dream, I would have lost my freedom, my financial freedom and my mental freedom. And that's quite a big opportunity cost. I would live in a beautiful house and be forever tied to paying it off. It's just not worth it. So that was one of the pivotal points in my life that I decided I wanted to pursue financial freedom for real. I didn't start investing until quite a while later, but that moment, that letting go of a long-term dream was a game changer. I would always ask myself, is that quitting? Did I give up and package this weakness as my conscious choice? Did I choose something easier over something better? But you know what? Only with time did I realize that my dreams change. I lived here on my own. I didn't need an extra room. My diet completely reshaped my cooking. I prepare very simple meals, and suddenly the kitchen was big enough. Yes, I still wanted a beautiful house, but not necessarily a bigger one. And not necessarily in London. And that hasn't changed even when my new boyfriend moved in and took over the second bedroom and started preparing sizzling steaks in the small kitchen. We change, and our dreams change with us. Our values shape our actions, and our values also change. And so I wanted to tell you this story about how letting go of something as big and wonderful as a dream made me realize how much I value freedom. There is no point in not quitting on something that doesn't serve you anymore. I quit my dream and it felt liberating. And once you start that process, you soon discover that you can repeat it because you've already done it before. You stretched your comfort zone. You discovered what matters to you most, or at least more. So what about this house? Time will tell, but I have a feeling that my hunger for financial freedom will decide about its fate. London is a great place, but once the choice becomes between being financially free or being a Londoner, I know which one I'll go for. Unless my dreams change again. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you soon.